that.
Amen.
Now run and tell that.
Amen, 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 amen. Don't start nothing.
Oh, yeah.
And it won't be nothing.
Help me.
It is what it is. Now run and tell that.
All right.
Have you ever heard news so exciting that you had to share it with someone else?
All right.
Good news is hard to keep.
Y'all been talking too much.
Yeah.
We feel that we must share it with someone else. The longer we hold it, the harder it gets to keep to ourselves.
All right.
Amen. Sometimes we don't even want to share it. We just want to show it.
That's right.
Now y'all talk to me now.
Right.
Amen. Get that new car. You don't call nobody. You just want to
show it off.
In a variety of ways, we have all shared special moments that were especially exciting.
Uh-huh.
Those moments we best savored, however, when they were shared with others.
Right.
When bargain hunters hear that there is going to be a sale, they quickly pick up the phone to tell a friend about red tag sales.
All right.
75% off specials are going out of business sales. Y'all know what I'm talking
about.
When someone has had a baby or cheated victory, the news spreads fast.
Right.
Bad news spread even faster. Hmm. Outrunning good news by a mile a minute. Y'all talk to me. Amen. I don't know how they did before they got all this modern technology.
Yeah.
Amen. But I beat Mama Gates and they heard it through the
grapevine.
Amen. Amen. You live way down here in the woods. Somebody way up there in New York already know your business.
That's it.
It appears everyone wants to be the first to tell exciting news, whether it is good or bad.
All right.
Y'all gonna talk to me. Every smile you see,
look out, God.
It really not a smile because they're glad to see you. They smile because they heard something of it. Consider the old man who spent a lifetime collecting valuable antiques. Experts value his collections worth millions of dollars. The old man had no heir, and he spent his time gazing at a picture of his son that was drawn by a little boy. Amen. He was just 12 years old. It was poorly drawn. Amen. In an artistic work. It had no value except that it had the likeness of his son, who died in the Great War.
All right.
One day it was announced that the old man had died.
All right.
With no heirs, his entire collection of antiques would be up for sale.
Yeah.
The entire city was abuzz with news that passed from one house, amen, to the next. Each person seemed to run from house to house, telling all the great antique bargains that would be up for sale cheaply. Y'all talk to me. On the day of the auction, people gathered from many states. The auctioneer announced that the auction would begin with the simple drawing.
Yeah.
Amen. Of the old man's son.
Uh-huh.
He asked for $100. After a long pause, he asked again, but there was still no taker.
Uh-huh.
Someone yelled, "Skip the picture,
uh-huh,
and let's get down to the real auction."
All right. Yeah.
But the auctioneer said the terms of the auction,
uh-huh,
amen, was that the picture had to be first.
Uh-huh.
And then a friend of the old man's recognized that it was a sketch,
uh-huh,
amen, of his son, and offered $100 for the pencil drawing.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And the auctioneer now sold. Amen. He promptly closed the auction.
Uh-huh.
The crowd was angry because they chance to bid on millions of dollars in antiques. Dawson Neal said the auction was over because the old man, amen, will say, whoever gets the sum gets it all. Today, there are many people who tell everything they know. Amen. But the one thing they should tell, they don't. Y'all talk to me. They should tell people about the Son. I'm talking about the Son of God. They should tell people that God's Son came, died, and rose by faith. They should tell them that if they get the Son, they get forgiveness, blessings, and eternal life. Tell them they get it all. Amen. What they should tell, they keep to themselves. But yet, it's the best news of the day. Yeah, y'all talk to me. They'll tell everything but their business.
That's right.
They'll tell all your business.
Yes, sir.
But they ain't gonna tell you none of their. This text focuses on the action, amen, of the women and the disciples on the morning of Christ's resurrection. Christ was crucified and buried in a newly hewn tomb owned by Joseph. It was guarded by soldiers upon the request of the religious leaders who feared the Christ's disciples will come by night and steal his body. Right. After 3 days and night, Mary came early Sunday morning to anoint his body with spices.
Yes.
When she arrived, she found the stone rolled away.
Yes.
And the tomb was empty.
Yes.
She was told by the angel to go quickly and tell the others. Right. In other words, run and tell them. She ran and delivered the news. When Peter and John heard the news, amen, they ran.
Yes.
John outran Peter. But when he reached the tomb, amen, he was afraid to go inside. He stooped and looked in, but did not enter. Peter, amen, did not run as fast as John. But he was the first one of the two to actually go inside the tomb.
All right.
He now witnessed that Christ had actually risen from the dead.
Yes,
amen. Folks, I like Christ is still dead.
Right.
Amen. To come to church and just sit down like Christ is still dead.
All right, now.
Amen. Tell my life about Christ living there, but you sit there and say it now.
Right.
Amen. Just like he's still dead.
All right.
The two of them ran to tell others what they had seen.
Right.
They were excited. Y'all were talking.
Right.
They were revived because the Master had done as he said he would.
Yes.
Amen. He had risen from the dead.
Yes.
Mary told what, but not the why.
Right.
Mary told what happened. Amen. His body is gone.
Uh-huh.
But she didn't tell why, because she did not fully understand.
Uh-huh.
Amen. What she saw.
Uh-huh.
Your body trying to tell something that you really don't know nothing about.
Yeah.
Your body tell somebody what they say.
Because
I'm still trying to figure out who is they say. Is that a male or female? Who know what has happened to them in life, but not fully apprehended the why. Mary knew, amen, that the ground shook. She knew that the stone was rolled away. She knew that there was no body in the tomb, but she did not know why. John told the wind, amen, but not the how. John was the fastest runner.
Yes,
in terms of opportunity, he was fine, but he could not go no further because at the tomb he did not have the courage, amen, to go in.
All right.
amen, of the resurrection than the other, because he arrived at the empty tomb first. But lack the courage to step into the unknown. Like so many of us, John prepared, ran fast, but lack the courage to seize the opportunity before him. John ran when he heard the news of the empty tomb. Amen. But when it came time to seize the day, he did not. Amen. Know how to make himself step into the dark and gloomy unknown. Peter, amen, had the most to tell. Peter was the last one, amen, to the tomb. But he had the most to tell because he actually went in and saw the evidence of the risen Lord for himself. Peter saw the folded cloak. Amen. And the tomb's interior. Yes. The oil suggested that Christ had done just what he said. He was convinced. Y'all talk to him. He saw it for himself. Likewise, those who have experienced Christ, amen, for themselves, have the most to tell. Let them have more to tell about Christ's life-reviving ability. Amen. Than anyone else, because he experienced it for himself. The man who sat by the pool for 38 years could testify to Christ's healing because he experienced it in himself. Now run and tell that. Somebody in here tonight know that the Lord is alive and waiting. Somebody in here can tell somebody and then had a touch from the Lord. When they all left the empty tomb, they had a testimony. Some more than others. But they had a story to tell. That's the way it is with every believer. We all have a story to tell. What we tell about the Lord is that same avenue the disciples heard on the morning of the resurrection. God is still a good God. I wish I had me so busy to do. If you just tell a man something, tell the world that God is a protecting God. Like David, we can testify from our own experience that God is our refuge and strength. That he's a very present help in a time of trouble. If you want to tell something, run and tell them. If you just have to tell something, tell the world that God is a blessed God. Somebody here has been blessed of the goodness of the Lord. Somebody here is even better. Somebody is sleeping better. Somebody is riding better than they have been. The Lord is blessing him. If you just have to tell something, tell the world that God is blessing me in the morning. He's blessing me in the new day. He's blessing me in the midnight. Every day, the Lord is blessing me. I'm running. Pick
The door.